In this video, I will discuss some work energy and power problems from previous year's question papers of JEE Main. This is the first question. A mass of m kg is suspended by a weightless string. The horizontal force that is required to displace it until the string makes an angle of 45 degrees with the initial vertical direction is. You can pause the video and attempt this question. This is the solution. So initially the mass m is in a vertical position attached to a string of length l, and a horizontal force is applied throughout until it makes an angle of 45 degrees with the vertical. So what is the work done in moving from here to here and the application of this constant force? So the work done is F into displacement F dot t equal to the increase in the potential energy of this mass m. So F dot t is F into the component of the displacement along the direction of force. So the component of the displacement along the direction of force is this distance. So this is L. So this is L by root 2. So F into the displacement along the direction of the force is L by root 2, which is equal to the increase in the gravitational potential energy, which is mg into increase in height. Increase in height is this distance. From here to here it is L by root 2, and this full length is L. So this distance is L minus L by root 2. So this is the increase in height, so mgh, h is this one. So from this you get the constant force as mg into root 2 minus 1. So the correct option is option 4. This is the next question. A 2 kg block slides on a horizontal floor with a speed of 4 meters per second. It strikes an uncompressed spring and compresses it until the block is motionless. The kinetic friction force is 15 newton and spring constant is 10,000 newton per meter. The spring compresses by. Here is the solution. So initially the block which moves the speed of 4 meters per second will come and touch the spring, and after they will start compressing it until its velocity becomes zero. So we can write the energy equation taking this as initial condition, this as final condition. So the initial energy equal to the final energy plus the work done by the system. So the initial energy is the kinetic energy of this block, half mv square, and the final energy is the kinetic energy, potential energy stored in the spring. The kinetic energy of the block is zero because the velocity has become zero. So it's half kx square plus the work done in moving this block from here to this position. This is the work done against the friction. So the friction force F into the distance moved, that is x, that is the same distance by which the spring is getting compressed. So using the velocity of value of velocity V as 4 and K as 10,000 newton per meter, and the friction force is given as 15. So this is a quadratic equation in x. So we can solve this using the formula minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So this is 13 into 10 raised to the power 4 plus 225, which is approximately 32 into 10 raised to the power 4, and this is approximately square root of this is 36, so approximately 6. So from this we get the approximate value as 5.85. So the correct option is option 1. This is the next question. An athlete in Olympic Games covers a distance of 100 meters in 10 seconds. His kinetic energy can be estimated to be in the range. So the athlete is covering 100 meter distance in 10 seconds. Assuming he is moving with a constant speed, the velocity is 100 by 10. That is the distance traveled by the time taken. So it's 10 meters per second. So the kinetic energy can be estimated as half mv square. And we can put an estimate value of the mass as 70 kg of the athlete. So from this we get the estimate as 3.5 to 10 raised to cube joules. So it's order of 10 raised to the power 3. So 3.5 is somewhere in between. So the correct option is option 4. This is the next question. The potential energy function for a force between two atoms in a diatomic molecule is approximately given by u equal to this expression, where a and b are constants and x is the distance between the atoms. If the dissociation energy of the molecule D is u at x equal to infinity minus u at x equal to equilibrium, then D is. You can positively attempt this question. Here is the solution. So dissociation energy is u at infinity and u at equilibrium. If you put x equal to infinity, the denominator will become very large. A and B are finite numbers, so u will become 0. So D is the value of potential energy at equilibrium with the negative sign. To find the equilibrium equation, we have to find the value of x for which u becomes minimum. U will be a minimum point. To get the minimum point, we can differentiate u with respect to x. So we will get this expression. And for u dash to be 0, we will get the value of x as b by 2a raised to the power minus 1 by 6. So this is the equilibrium position. So putting this value of x in the expression for u, we get the value of u at equilibrium position as minus b square by 4a. So the dissociation energy is b square by 4a. So the correct option is option 4. This is the next question. At time t equal to 0, particle starts moving along x-axis. If its kinetic energy increases uniformly with time t, the net force acting on it must be proportional to. So it's been said kinetic energy increases uniformly with time t, so kinetic energy is proportional to the time t, and kinetic energy is half mv square. So from that we get the velocity as proportional to t raised to the power half. And force is mass into acceleration, so it goes as acceleration, and acceleration is dv by dt. And b goes as t raised to the power half, and denominator is time. So t raised to the power half divided by t is t raised to the power minus half. So the correct option is option 4. This is the next question. This question has statement 1 and statement 2. Of the 4 choices given after the statements, choose the one that best describes the 2 statements. If 2 springs S1 and S2 of 4 constants K1 and K2 respectively are stretched by the same force, it is found that more work is done on spring S1 than on S2. Statement 1 is, if stretched by the same amount, work done on S1 will be more than that of S2. Statement 2 is K1 is less than K2. So 4 options are given. So we have to find whether statement 1 and statement 2 are true or false, and whether the 2 statements are related. You can pause the video and attempt this question. Here is the solution. So the work done in stretching a spring by distance x is half kx square. So the work done in stretching the first spring is half k1 x1 square. And the force that is stretching this spring is F. So that should equal to k1 into x1, where x1 is the final extension. So the work done can be written as half F into x1. And this can also be written as half F square by k1 using this relation. So since the same force is applied to both 1 and 2, the 2 springs, so W1 is, and it's been given that W1 is greater than W2. More work is done on spring S1 than S2. That means W1 is greater than W2. So this is given. So from this we get K1 as less than K2. So now let's analyze the statements. You stretch by same amount, work done on S1 will be more than S2. So stretching by same amount means X1 and X2 are same. Since F is same, then W1 is equal to W2. So the statement 1 is false. Statement 2 is that K1 is less than K2, and that is true. So the correct option is option 2.